But Father, if I'm to be married to an army officer...
Then you've got to learn how to take orders.
You've never seen men die in battle, Junior. And I hope you never do.
I've already told you. I agree with your father.
Army officers. I can see there's no point in arguing with you two. But things will seem awfully dull in Salem.
Buying a trousseau, preparing a wedding. Dull. What kind of girl are you?
Oh, you've got a lot to learn about me, Lieutenant Ray.
I'll be riding into Salem within a month. Goodbye, darling.
We've been through a lot together. As soon as our mother died, I don't know, it's not an easy thing to raise a daughter.
You've done a first-rate job, sir. I admire a woman with spirit.
Lieutenant Drake?
Sir.
You'll inform me as soon as the gallows are ready.
Yes, sir.
Outside. The gallows will be ready in a few minutes now, Boone. I detest waste.
The idea of swinging at the end of the rope doesn't make me too happy either.
But it doesn't have to happen.
Why? Have you changed your conditions? No. Well, then what are we talking about?
Enter.
Everything is ready, sir.
I'm willing to drop the condition that you arrange a treaty between us and the Shawnee.
You still expect me to tell my friends and neighbors that I was wrong when I advised them to fight for their rights?
A public retraction of your treasonous statements against the Crown is essential.
And impossible.
Corporal! Escort the prisoner to the gallows.
Daniel Boone, you've been found guilty of treason against His Royal Majesty King George III. The penalty by order of the commandant of this post is death by hanging. Sergeant?
Sir.
Proceed to carry out the sentence.
Yes, sir.
Junior!
walk, woman. But I will kill you here.
Those men! You just murdered them! Murdered them!
Yes, I murdered them. And I will murder many more. Now walk!
Hold! Tompkins!
Sir!
This is where they ambushed the carriage.
I'll look for signs ahead, sir.
You two men, fan out. Look for signs of the trail.
Here, sir. There's been a scuffle here, sir.
All right, on the double.
Sergeant, you better stay behind me. The brakes single trail make less noise that way. And remembering what your colonel's orders were, my back will make you a nice, big, broad target.
And now, Boone, General Braddock could have used the likes of you.
You were with Braddock? I mean, left at Worm.
We were 1,000, but only a handful of us survived. The Indians outwitted us. We walked right into it.
That's what your lieutenant's trying to do.
Go!
Hold it! Rest a moment. Lieutenant!
What?
It's Julius. She's leaving a trail.
I think you're heading east, sir.
Corporal, be alert for any other signs. Have the men proceed.
Fall in, men!
Can't go any further.
Weaklings. Like all the women of the whites. Soft and useless.
Some water, please. Please.
Maybe when you learn to butcher deer, gather wood, and look after Penango's needs, I will let you be my squaw. Soon, you will whimper like child.
Where the girl? She'll lead us right to those murdering savages. Forward, straight ahead.
Look at them. They're walking right into that trap.
Looks peaceful enough.
You're not using your eyes, Sergeant. There's only one engine down there, probably to close the trap from behind.
Well, they'd better be running.
Not just yet. Penango's using Julia as bait to trap Drake, and we need Drake as our own piece of cheese. Don't worry, Sergeant. We're going to leave the back door open for your men. I'll probably pick up something I'll need later. Come on.
Another sign.
They seem to have changed direction, sir. To the north.
That's strange. Very well, Tompkins. Have the men step up the march.
Forward!
Why did they not follow? Have they forgotten you so soon?
There she is. Aye, the poor lass looks like she's been through hell.
Yeah, I'm sure she has.
It's going to take some doing to get her out of there.
An angle!
Redcoats were lost. I had to send my braves to lead them to my trap.
Sergeant, we've got only one chance to try and save her. Under the circumstances, we better wait till night to do it.
Them, Tompkins. Completely lost, sir. All right, have the men fall in and we'll proceed.
Yes, sir.
Fall in, men.
Up! March!
Well, there's less than an hour of sunlight left. Better try to work our way up behind them.
Boone! There's the lieutenant, and he's headed right for them again.
Now we'll have to get closer.
Into a lion's mouth with their eyes wide open.
Now they've got to be warned.
It's
That's just what I'm going to do, Sergeant.
I suggest you lower your voice.
What do you think you're doing?
I'll tell you when we move your men out of here.
Corporal, place this man in irons.
Begging your pardon, Lieutenant, but the Indians are waiting in ambush for you right over the knoll.
How did you get here, Sergeant? Why are you dressed like that?
Please, sir, we're under orders from the Colonel, and I suggest that you do what Mr. Boone says.
I'll tell you when we move your men to safer cover.
Squad!
Quietly.
All right, hold it here. Now, I demand an explanation.
Lieutenant, before you and I start talking, I suggest you send a couple of men out there in the trees in case Penango saw our move.
Tompkins.
Sir.
Take Sims and Jennings.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Boone, I had those Indians on the run.
That's what they wanted you to think. You were walking into a passel of arrows, Lieutenant, a trap.
You said something about orders, Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
I assume you're aware of what these say.
Mm-hmm.
The way I read them, this only delays your execution.
That's right. Unless the Colonel's daughter is returned safely to the fort.
Unless you are responsible for saving her life.
Well, I expect the Colonel will take your word for that, Lieutenant, if we manage to rescue her. There's more in there than that.
I can read, Mr. Boone. The Colonel clearly states that I and my men are to take orders from you.
That's right. I figure if you and I fight Penango instead of each other, we might have a chance. My way.
I already said I understood the orders, Mr. Boone.
Good. Let's start by moving out of here. Penango will be wondering what happened to you.
All right, men. Form up.
Those red coats. We're gonna have a full moon tonight.
I kept these things that you asked me to. Now, what would you have me do with them?
Now, just hang on to the loops, and I'll tell you later.
And Mr. Boone, take it easy on him. He's been trained for years to become an officer and a gentleman, and you can't change that all in one day.
I'm going to have to try, Sergeant. A girl's life depends on it. And ours.
going around. I'll stay here and hold them off.
Got everyone, sir.
You all right, Sergeant?
Not a scratch.
I want to apologize, Mr. Boone.
Don't you think we ought to be getting back to the fort, Lieutenant?
At your pleasure. Tompkins? Have the men fall in.
Yes, sir.
Line up! Forward! March!
Pleasant sight there.
Dismantling the gallows? Yes, for me too. I've never had to hang a man. I don't relish the idea.
Well, the way things are going, Colonel, you might be a little premature. That is, if you insist on hanging everybody who talks against your king.
But he's your king too, Boone.
Well, now that's what it's all about, Colonel, but if you don't mind, I'll just leave that argument for later.
Well, at least it doesn't prevent me from expressing my appreciation. I'm a very, very grateful father, Boone. Enter.
Carriage is ready, sir.
Thank you, Sergeant. Sergeant.
Sir.
Look at yourself.
Sir? I can't rightly explain how that happened, sir. Unless maybe it's because the boots are so much more comfortable than the... Yes, sir! Immediately, sir!
You're leaving none too soon, Boone. A few more days and British military discipline in this fort would be a shambles.
I might even be able to convince your men they're on the wrong side, Colonel.
You know, I like you, Boone. I hope we never meet again.